Hi, my name is Dave Garland. We are at Mont-Sainte-Anne, Round 4 World Cup. This week's tech section for chain reaction cycles is going to be a strip and rebuild of Matt Simmonds' 2012 RC3 Marzocchi 888 fork. For 2012, the features of this fork, you have spring preload on the right hand leg. You've got an air volume progression adjustment, which is this silver adjuster. The red adjuster is for rebound, and the gold adjuster on the lower left is for compression damping. So to begin to strip the fork, we need to take the adjusters off first. So remove your spring preload, being careful because there's a spring and a detent ball underneath each of these adjusters under your top caps. So in the right side leg, we've got spring spacer, and in Matt Simmonds' case, this is a 7.7 spring. We switch between 7.7 and 6.5 depending on the steepness of the track really, and low speed hits as well. So in the left side, you've got the air volume assembly. So on your initial strip down of the fork, if you find that you've got some oil sat above your air volume adjuster, it means that you may have to replace the O-ring that's sat in the top. Normally, this can occur if you run deep into your progression adjustment. You've got 22 clicks. If you continually run deep into this progression adjustment, then there's some other adjustments you need to make to compensate to help the fork out in its progression. Okay, so 15 mil socket. If you hold the stanchion up and just gently undo the foot nut with your hand, you'll see oil beginning to come out of the leg. Let it run into a catch tray. For 2012, you can see that these stanchions are gold. That's going to be included for 2012 in the RC3 range. We can tell you more about that stanchion when there's a release date nearer to the end of the year. Okay, so now we're going to remove the left side cartridge, which is our compression, rebound, and air volume progression adjuster. 17 mil. Remove the compression adjuster just by using a pair of pin nose pliers. Grab it tight and pull it down. It's just held on by a small O-ring, which you need to remove as well to get the socket on. Okay, so with a 17 mil socket, you can remove the left side foot nut. You're gonna see 300 cc's of 7.5 weight oil come out of the lower leg. So to get all of the suspension oil out of the cartridge, you just need to cycle it up and down slowly. You need to make sure all of the oil is out of the fork. If you don't make sure that you have no oil left in the fork when you come to refill at your specific oil quantity and there's some still left in the leg, you'll find that the fork won't get full travel. It's real critical that you get oil height correct. Give the stanchion a wipe with a lint-free cloth or rag. You can have a little inspection just to see what the wear is on the stanchion, if there is any. Always, when you're working with a lower and the stanchions and the crowns are removed, you always work on the clamped leg. You never work on a lower leg that's not clamped, because in this state, the lower is very fragile, so only work on the clamped leg. What we're going to do now is to remove the dust wiper and the oil seal. We're going to use basically a large screwdriver that's been softened. The edges of it are not sharp anymore, so it's an ideal tool for you to remove the seals without damaging any of the aperture that the new seals are going to sit in. With the fork and the lowers fully stripped, we can just perform a cleaning operation. Just some heavy duty degreaser. It's important that you use a degreaser that actually dries oil. So you can spray, just to check, you can spray onto your finger and you can see that if you blow on it slightly, it completely evaporates. That's a good quality degreaser that leaves no after film. So you know your forks internally are gonna be real clean. Okay, so once we've cleaned the aperture of the lower legs, now we're gonna reinsert new oil seals and dust wipers. So making sure that you've got the oil seal the right way up. Take your insert tool. Initially, just press it into place. Once the seal doesn't feel like it's going to move anymore, just take a soft blow hammer and just gently tap it into place. You'll be able to feel it stop because the hammer feels like it wants to rebound off the seal insert tool. So that's just a good indication that it's all the way home. Clean off your retaining clip for your oil seal. You push this into place with your fingers. If it doesn't want to go into place into the groove, it possibly could mean that the oil seal needs to sit down a little bit more. So, you know, you can just double check. If it doesn't want to sit in its groove properly, just give it another tap and just double check. So with your dust wiper, you replace, just place this initially. You can use finger and thumb pressure just to make sure that it's in place correctly. If you take half of your insert tool, you can just press the rest of the seal home. Because you're using half, you can see that the seal is going in correctly. If you just work your way around, you can make sure that all the outer edge of the dust wiper is in line with the lower legs. Then one of the most important things for, you know, for a racer's fork is keeping it working smooth for a long period of time. With the 888, normally comes with a dust wiper foam ring that actually sits in between the oil seal and the dust wiper. We remove that and we use Stendek super fine easy glide grease. It's a very, very fine grease that keeps everything working real smooth, stops any dirt getting past the layer of grease and into the fork. So, and it's a small thing you can do that actually makes the fork work real smooth for a lot longer. Take our stanchion, gently insert the stanchion and begin to roll it into place. The reason why you roll it into place is so you don't catch any lips when you press the fork in, and you'll feel that it will go past the dust wiper and oil seal lips very easily, and you can insert the stanchion fully in to the lower leg with no resistance. If you do have any resistance, then it could be that you've caught a lip of a seal, so remove and just check and reinsert. So first, in Matt's fork we're running for this weekend, the 7.7 spring, we push the spring into place. Then we can take our foot nut, push the spring down. Always tighten the foot nut first by hand to make sure that you've got it. Ooh, make sure you've got it firmly in place. There is a shoulder that it sits on, so if you're unsure, if you can just move the foot nut side to side to make sure it's located properly. Holding the spring, you can tighten down the foot nut. The reason why I use a short wrench means you can't over tighten it. You can feel what the nut's doing when it bites and doesn't really want to turn anymore. Then you can almost guarantee that it's tight enough. So now we've secured the foot nut with the right hand stanchion. We're just going to insert our cleaned control leg, which has got the compression rebound and volume adjust. We take our foot nut. This is an intricate little foot nut. It's got a small seal that sits inside. You need to make sure that that's in there. If it's not in there, the fork will leak almost immediately. So it's really important, just a little check. Once you've tightened your foot nut, finger tight, take the 17mm socket, Now we're ready to fill the fork off. The stock oil capacities for the 888 RC3, the spring leg has normally 80 to 100 millilitres or cc's of 7.5 weight oil. The damper side normally has 320 millilitres or cc's. Okay, so that's our spring leg. Filled off. Make sure you insert the spring guide, which helps the spring stay level and in the center of the stanchion. Reinsert your top cap. Okay, so once you've filled the damper leg, you need to cycle the oil inside the lower part of the leg to fill the cartridge, so you remove any initial air gaps. You do that by simply pushing the cartridge down inside the stanchion, lifting it up and down, and you'll begin to feel the oil fill into the cartridge. And when you've got a completely filled cartridge, you'll feel that the stroke is the same, or the resistance to flow for the cartridge shaft is the same all the way up. Okay, so once you've done that, you can just hold your cartridge side top cap up to the top, lift, so just to make the assembly of the top caps easier, just use a small amount of grease. Basically, that's our strip rebuild and tuning ready for first practice day tomorrow, Mont-Sainte-Anne World Cup round 4.